Good afternoon. Welcome to Tenkenkan Echo's The Daily Ramble. Please remember, share, subscribe, thumbs up, and comment. It is July the 24th, and it is kind of a nice day outside. Actually, I'm about to head out and go to Susukino or Odori and meet one of the other ALTs who is leaving to pick up and obtain a new toaster. Haha! A toaster! I don't know why. I just thought I'd take it off his hands. I don't actually toast bread very much, but, you know, maybe, whatever, it'd be good to have. Yeah, so there's that. And yeah, so today, well, last night I had really bad insomnia. And I don't really know why. You know, I think the temperature went up, maybe something like that. I was flipping about like a fish in my bed until like 3 o'clock in the morning, but I got up at about a quarter after 10, half past 10, and then kind of tried not to get out of bed until almost 11. Then I did and did my Japanese homework and had a shower, and here I am. So yeah, I will be going out just for a short bit. I'm not going out too far. I might take pictures, might not, and then I'll come back because it's already the middle of the day, 2 o'clock. And this photo is actually of Lake Shikotsu. Sorry, I was checking Shikotsu. So Lake Shikotsu, and I believe the picture is facing west-ish, because if you head off the side of the picture where the tents are, around that bay is an inn or a hotel. It basically has onsen, but natural onsen. It's not, or spring-fed onsen. It's not sento. Sento is sort of like the indoor manufactured onsen, or hot springs, hot baths. There we go. And onsen are sort of natural heated, you know, thermal heated baths, for lack of a better word. And something I really recommend if you come to Japan is going out into sort of more rural areas and visiting these inns and spending time in the onsen there. So this one in particular actually sits, there are two, there's sort of an indoor one that's spring fed, like you actually, you know, it's fed from the mountains itself. And it's the orange colored one. So lots of iron in the water, I believe. And it's actually quite nice. You can sit on a deck and look out over the lake. And the other part of the onsen that you go to is actually lakeside. So it's the same level as the lake water. And there's a wall that's built up from stone in the local area at the edge of the lake. And it has sort of, you know, cuts in the wall to let the lake water in. And you can sit out there in the pouring rain if you want to, in the winter, in the snow. And the onsen is fed from the mountainside. And you sit on pebbles, basically in heated water, outside at the lake, in the lake water, that's kind of heated as you sit there. It's really nice. And not too expensive, like 800 yen, which is about $8 American or about $10 Canadian. And you can get cheaper ones in cities, or you could get a little more expensive and go to a place like Jozanke, which are really nice. But, you know, if you want sort of a more kind of removed and less packed, I guess, experience, then that's the place to go, is the remote ones. Now, I do recommend going with someone who is Japanese, because, you know, they can sort of explain things, unless you're good enough at using Japanese, comfortable enough that you don't mind being there by yourself. One of the things that this campground had is everybody camps on the beach. Now, you can't go swimming in the water, and this is partly because it's dangerous and they don't have lifeguards there, but like the water's really nice. I jumped in. I didn't realize I couldn't swim until afterwards. So I came back and we found out when we left, it's like, oh, hey, no swimming here. Oops. And that's partly for cleanliness of the water, but also because it's really dangerous. Like, it's a pit just about 10 feet out from the edge. You can't touch. Like, you have to go way down. It's a good 3 meters deep, so it goes like this, and it is fresh water. It's really quite nice, and I believe there's a volcano off on the other side of the picture, and yeah, it's a really nice place to kind of be and relax. So I recommend it. I definitely recommend going out camping in the wilderness and sort of campgrounds that are all over Japan. And camping is a big thing. Beachside camping and stuff is a big thing in Japan. And people are super respectful, clean up after themselves. And, you know, there's very little to almost no litter left on the beaches. So, you know, we could definitely take a page from that. This picture was taken last year in August 24th. So a month from now, it'll be a full year since I've been to that beach. I'll probably go camping earlier next month with a friend of mine. Again, just to get out of the city a bit and people. And people space out, like, you know, each of those three tents that you see in the photo there are three different encampments, two different encampments. And there were four near us, but everybody was 2 or 3 meters apart even then. So, you know, it's not like crowded beaches. There's not like tons of people out there, which is super cool. And I think I said super like 8 times. I don't know. Anyways, oh yeah, a point about baths when you come to Japan. When you're in onsen or sento, which are the man-made ones, you are naked. You can't wear a bathing suit or bathrobes or anything. You come in and you're naked. Now, you can wear like a nude shirt, for example, if you have tattoos, to hide your tattoos. But generally speaking, you shouldn't be wearing anything. And a lot of sento and onsen will say no tattoos, period. And this is because of the affiliation with tattoos and yakuza in Japan, which is the organized mafia. So you have to be pretty careful about if you have tattoos, even little ones. Some places will flat out ban you from it. So it's good to check and say, hey, I have a small tattoo on my ankle. Is that okay? And, you know, they might just say, yeah, whatever. But always check and, you know, respect them when they say no, because you don't want to make it worse for everybody else. And it sucks, but tattoos are not part of the mainstream culture in Japan. They are slowly changing the way of viewing. But you will be naked in front of other people of the same binary gender. So men bathe with men, women bathe with women. There are places where it is mixed baths, but those are very rare. And usually if you're going to those, you're attending with someone else who is Japanese, or you are fluent, and they know you there. So don't expect to be going to mixed baths anytime soon. And in mixed baths, often both genders wear towels around their bodies, and then when they sit in the water, they take them down or sit in the towels. So the structure of the bath is a bit different. And I don't actually know the name of the mixed onsens. There's a special title for them. There's a specific word that means mixed baths or mixed bathing. Anyways, that's it for today. I got to get ready and head out the door in a bit here. So catch you on the flip side and see you tomorrow. Ciao.